It seems that we finally have a new web performance metric that's not only user-centric, but that's actually valuable. I strongly believe this is how we're gonna measure web performance in 2020 and beyond. So if you wanna find out how to measure your website performance using this new metric, more info coming up. So for a few years now, most good developers measure web performance using all the user-centric web performance metrics, such as first contentful paint, first meaningful paint, and so on. The biggest problem with that is measuring those metrics at scale was close to impossible, because as with first contentful paint, it was pretty easy, whereas with meaningful paint, it was very difficult to assess which part of the website is actually meaningful for your users. Also, metrics like DOM content loaded, that I personally don't really like to use, don't really correspond with what your users see on the screen. And this was my biggest problem, my biggest beef with those metrics, that they didn't really correspond with real data. Metrics like first paint or first contentful paint were also kind of tricky, because for example, if your user is gonna see a splash screen, it's not really what we wanna measure here. And now it seems like we have a solution to that. The new metrics called Largest Contentful Paint comes to Chrome 77. Right now when I'm recording this video, my version of Chrome, which obviously updates automatically, is 76. So with a new next version of Chrome, of stable Chrome, and not Chromium, we're gonna see that built in into every single browser. Also, it kind of changes how Google is gonna collect the data about web performance. But let's get to that now. I reached out to Phil Walton, an engineer at Google who actually wrote an article about largest contentful paint, and he confirmed that this is something that Googlers, actually, I'm guessing the Chrome team is measuring, it's gonna start measuring, and this is something that's gonna be reflected in Crux, so Chrome User Experience Report, and we can only assume that this is gonna be one of the most important web performance metric that may also be moved onto the ranking factors, either mobile or desktop ranking factors in the future. But this also changes how we should look at how we optimize websites, because the metrics that are a little bit outdated for a while now, like first contentful paint, like DOM content loaded, that we had to optimize for a bit, are getting a little bit less important with this new cool metric. So let's talk a little bit about what largest contentful paint is. So largest contentful paint metric looks at the largest element rendered in the viewport. Those elements, and let me just look into the documentation, are obviously IMG, so images, vector images, so SVG formats as well, and video HTML markup as well. So if you have any of those in the viewport, like basically in the first view that you see when loading a page, they will see at the big, they will look at the, Chrome is gonna look at the biggest element and is gonna measure at which time this element is gonna load, and this is gonna be your largest contentful paint time, which is the fun part here is that basically it took Googlers and people at Chrome, and not only Chrome, a few years to come up with this metric, and coming up with basically the biggest element main sound may sound a little bit funny, because we're all expecting something very new and spectacular, but basically coming back to basics here makes it the most logical, and I'm guessing the easiest to measure web performance on scale, and gathering data from example from Chrome to measure how different websites load based on user-centric metrics. And you can read a little bit more about that in the link below this video. But generally, this metric is going to be available through Chrome API, so you can export that from Chrome when measuring your website. We're actually building a tool that's going to measure that pretty soon as well. We should publish that within on our website. The most exciting part about largest contentful paint is that this is a little bit more dynamic than the previous metrics we're looking at. Let's look at two examples presented by the author of the article on web.dev, who actually showed a quite interesting case studies of different websites loading and how the largest contentful paint may change. So the largest, actually the largest element may change, affecting where the largest contentful paint event takes place. If we look at the CNN website, there are actually three different elements that are marked as the largest element, but when the website is fully loaded, you can see that it moves from the headline to images. In the case of TechCrunch, we can see that the one of the paragraphs is being marked as the largest contentful paint for a second, and then it again moves onto the image. So this is a little bit, I like this metric a lot compared to previous ones, because it shows a little bit of like flexibility when measuring web performance. When the website is fully loaded, the largest contentful paint element may actually change, making the largest contentful paint time move forward. It basically change and to reflect the latest state and of the website that's fully loaded in the viewport. We can also see that sometimes the largest contentful paint element is going to remain the same. In the example of Instagram or Google, it doesn't change. So it also reflects how users see web performance, how it affects users. And it basically reflects that pretty well compared to, for example, first meaningful paint that was difficult to measure on scale, or first contentful paint that I never really liked, or even dumb content loaded that was outdated for a while now. I hope you're gonna find this new metric as exciting as I found it when reading the article by Philip Walton. I'm pretty sure it's gonna change how we measure web performance. I'm a little bit surprised that it's a little bit underappreciated, that it was this article and this topic wasn't as popular as I would expect in the both technical SEO, web performance and development community. But I guess it's gonna get the recognition it deserves pretty soon, when Google is gonna and Chrome team is gonna start rolling out that into Crux. Thank you so much. Thank you for watching. Make sure to subscribe and press the bell, and see you soon.